Ladies and gentlemen, welcome tonight. Thank you very much for being here. That was Riley Kinchlo, Outstanding Award winner, right there on the alto sax. Alright, welcome to the best and worst evening there is of the year. It's the best evening because it's the end of the year concert. It's the worst because we're saying goodbye to nine of our graduates tonight. We're going to have a good time, though, sending these guys out. You heard Unit 7, which was a piece of music arranged by my professor at Washington State University, Dr. Greg Yazanetsky. And that was our opener. What you see on stage right now is what's called our small group. So our group within our group. And this is the group that we compete with when we go down to CPC and to Mountain Hood. We're going to do two more tunes, and we're going to bring the rest of our gang on here and finish out the show. All right, so speaking of outstanding musicians and soloist award winners, we're going to move on to our ballad, and that is going to feature Sarah Welch on the tenor saxophone. We're going to get the microphone set up for her in just a minute. And to let you know that Sarah is one of the most decorated soloists that we've had in our history of jazz. She's one of our top two. She's had four outstanding soloist awards up until this point, three of them this year. So, without further ado, we're going to hear Sarah Welch, and this is entitled Overjoyed.
Thank you.
Okay, so I welcomed all of you here tonight. What I didn't welcome is all those people who are watching streaming. YouTube right up there with my good friend Tony Lewis. Tony, thank you for broadcasting this tonight, just like we've done for our basketball and softball games. So whoever's out there listening, watching, I hope you're enjoying the show so far. Thanks for being here, you guys in person as well. I need to do a little bit of talking, let these guys kind of gather themselves here a little bit. Before I ask for my alumni, I'm going to embarrass Sarah a little bit, but I need to. Sarah, would you stand up one more time, please? What I love so much about Colfax is the fact that our first drummer, who played for our first piece of Unit 7, Gunnar Ani, is no longer with us. He got up and left because he's an FFA, and they're having a state FFA with a pulpit. So he's got to go back over there and get involved with the things that are going there. Here's the other thing I like about this is that we had a softball game tonight, and our girls beat Colton 3-2, is that right? Come on. And we're not princesses up here, okay? So I want you to take a look right here, okay? Come on, Sarah, show us there you go. Now I guarantee you, there wasn't another saxophone player, a gal or a guy at CBC or Mount Hood had a patch right here from doing track and doing everything else that we have, all right? These are not princesses up here. These guys are real goals. Let's give these guys a big round of applause. Now what Sarah didn't want me to discuss is how that came about in the track meet. I'm just going to leave it by the way. I could say it was down the hallway, but we're going to leave the track. Okay? Now, right now, I need all my alumni, any of my alumni that have been here, please stand up and just wait for a moment. Come on, alumni, just stand up. Let's take a good look at you. Now, hold on. So, guys on stage, these are who the people you're standing on the shoulders of, right here. Alumni, I just want to let you know that we made our same stop in the Tri-Cities, okay? Then we stopped at the Dalles at 11:59, okay? And then we stopped at Multnomah Falls, okay? Couldn't go to the top this year, all right, because of the fires. We did everything the same. We went to the mall, we did all this stuff. So just to let you know that this brotherhood and sisterhood is still alive. We do the same things year in and year out and produce some good music. Let's give these alumni a great big round of applause. Thanks for being here, guys. Appreciate it. Alright, so this is what the alumni compare themselves with right now, the third tune. Okay? Everybody opens up and swing tune like we did Unit 7, everybody's got a ballad or whatever. But all these alumni are going, okay, remember the third tune that we played, and how hard that was. What are these pups? That's right, because these are all pups up here, right there, okay? 17 and 18 year olds and 14, 15, some 12 year olds up here, and all that, right? So too high, 11-year-olds are good, right? We got some young guys up here, which is great. We're gonna have some more young guys join us here in just a little bit. So the third tune is what we're looking for. So I got to listen to this piece of music about 2 years ago. I got to listen to Greg Yozaniski's band over at Washington State play this. They played this in the November concert that we saw, and I thought, oh, that's a good looking tune. I don't know if we can pull it off. I played it for our guys, and they all went, let's try it. And I think they pull it off pretty well. This one's entitled Apollo's Real. We have two solos on this. We're going to go back to Ryan Kitchell on the alto sax and Abby Miller on the trumpet. Entitled Apollo's Real. Thank you. Matthew Miller, Riley Kinslow. Okay, so a couple things about our playing here. Now we bring our large group up. Our large group plays in everything. All of these guys who just came up on stage know all the tunes that we just got done playing. Regulations tell you that you can only go when you compete at CBC, Mountain Hood, University of Iowa, wherever you go. But you only have 20 to 22, 24 people on stage at any one point. So you have to narrow it down to a traditional sax section, 4, 5, 6, and bones, and then trumpets, and then one on each part. So now I get to bring up all my other casts. So the doubles, everybody who's been doubling on the music all year, to take their place in case, you know, my lead trumpet player takes a bad ground or into the chops, and I've got somebody who can take care of it. Okay? So, or somebody skins their elbow on the track as she's running down. Okay, so right now it's time to introduce our groups. So first of all, we're going to introduce our saxophones. Saxophones, when I call your name, would you please stand up? Everybody hold your applause while I give you all 100 saxophones. Altos, Ryan Kitchelow, Jan Ng, Zoe Burt, Kerry Largent, Lexi Booth, Jonathan Kinley. Okay, tenor sax, Sarah Welchum, Kirsten York, Devin Becker, Barry Sax, Allison Pugh, Reed McGraw. Got everybody? That's my saxophone section. Okay, now, I know because I've got administration here in the building tonight, and I know they're thinking, what are we paying him for? He talks, he gets up and starts, and then he goes off and he waves his hands and then they quit, and then he goes back and talks. That's really bad. You need to really knock my pay, because that's all I'm going to do. Just an MC tonight. Letting these guys get out here and show you what they've got. Here's the other great thing. Now, this band right here that you see up here is also our pep band, so our winter pep band. And these guys got to play at the state title game for our girls' state basketball championship. So this band has a lot of exposure. A lot of people know this band, they've heard this band, okay? So these guys get to roar and play without me. In fact, when I'm down speaking at the state conference or the Northwest Conference, these guys go with a supervisor, okay? And they go off and they play at all these games and they load up the bus and they get off the bus and they play and they do all this stuff. And I've been told numerous times by the seniors that they don't need me. So I'm going to continue to do what I'm doing, talk a little bit, wave a little bit, and then come back over here to my corner and stay here the rest of the night. The rest of the tunes you're going to hear right now are all pep band. All of the signed on by the seniors, all the stuff they wanted to play on their last night. So the last night, they'd have cake, ice cream. These are the tunes that they wanted to play. And we're going to start off with another Stevie Wonder piece. It's a great chart entitled, Don't You Worry About a Thing. We also have Abby Miller on the trumpet. So, two Stevie Wonder charts here. I'm a child of the 60s and 70s, so how should it be? Alright, so, we got some more introductions. Let's, since they're already standing in the middle row and the back row, all you have to do is wave your hand. I'm going to introduce my outstanding award-winning trombone section. Let me tell you how that works. When we go down to CBC, when we go down to Hood, we're all in different rooms, in different buildings. So, 2 years ago, we were in the 1As, because that's our category, the 1As and the 3As. And then the 2As and the 4As are in a different room. So, it's pretty much based on like what we do for sports, size-wise. But music opens that range up a little bit. So we end up going up against a lot of groups that are a lot bigger than we are. So in our section this last year, we went 1As and 2As, or in CBC, rather, in April. And they pick the most outstanding saxophone, trombone, trumpet, and rhythm section throughout the whole building. So out of 20 bands that play that morning, that afternoon, they find one that they're most impressed with, and the judges picked Colfax trombone section. So, let's give this one a hand. Now, for two of them, my seniors, this is your second one, is that right? And the second one in your careers? That's pretty impressive. You must have a great teacher. Okay. Trombones. I'm a pretty good trombone player. Okay? Okay. John Bones, wave your hand, Kia Miller, Derek Ward, Jacob Brown, Gene Gibbler, trombones. Trumpets in the back row, Abby Miller, Aiden Miller, Mark Morgan, Jacob Jones, Anna Cocky, Austin Miller, Isaac Anderson, and Cal Lewis. That's our whole brass section. Again, so stories of on the road and all the things that we're doing. We're at Mount Hood. And one of my favorite clinicians, one of my favorite people in the whole world, his name is Chris Brugate. Chris is related to the Brugates here in town. And Chris is the director of bands at Central Washington. Back when I first started as a teacher 30 years ago, he was at McMinnville in Portland area, then moved up to Mount Hood, and then later on went to Central. Well, he's given a clinic. Our kids are in, we got done playing at 12 o'clock. And he's given a clinic in the 4A session, so the great big bands, those guys that had 2,000 kids in their high school. And Chris gets up there and he's pretty animated and he says, okay, and you guys gotta get after this thing. And he said, you know, your stances and all that stuff. He said, how many of you guys play football? Well, you knew what the answer to that one is at a 4A. Nobody raised their hand. I looked down the audience and all my guys were raising their hand. And I thought, man, it's good to be a small school, right? So he got down and tried to show those guys what a football stance looked like. It wasn't very good, okay? And Chris has worked with my bands, he's adjudicated my bands, he's judged my bands. So right away, I fired off a quick text and said, hey, Chris, that football stance needs some work. Call me, we'll get together. So he didn't think it was very funny. I thought it was hilarious. Moving on, enough of the stories. Here's another great tune that we do. Again, released from the 70s. This is entitled Frankenstein. We're going to feature our senior drummer, Dane Hall, on the drums. Frankenstein. We'll be right back. worry, Mr. and Mrs. Hall, you will not have to buy me a new drum set. Right? We built that one to last. We're going to be in good shape. Right? All right, rhythm section. Guys, we just got done listening to. Let's introduce these guys real quick. Ready? Pianos. Four ladies over there. Elizabeth Harwood, Jana Harwood, Hayden Folson, Olivia Neen. On the bass guitar, Chelsea Becker, Lauren Kennedy, and Cindy Miller. On the drums, you just heard from Dane Licious Hall, Kyle Dale, Gunnar Ani, Josh Huber, Anthony Becker, McCoy Nelson, Ryan Bodie, Trace Henniger, Jude Hahn, and Ryder Limbo. That's our rhythm section right there. Okay, so let me tell you a couple things again about our rhythm section. What I love about alumni here, what's pretty cool about the things that we do and playing as much pep band as we do and these young kids watching the bands growing up and being up near the mezzanine up there where we're playing with these boys and girls basketball, which is that soon-to-be drummers. Those are the kids you can see they're running up and down. Okay, moms and dads, you know you're going to have a drummer if they're running up and down. They're beating up things and those doing something. I knew Kellen was going to be that when he was little. Right? But drummers pass down licks. They pass down things from group to group to group to group. And there are some things that guys will go off and do their own things. And there's some licks that I continue to hear, like for 10 or 12 years or 15 years from some of my alumni drummers who did the same thing. That kind of stuff. It stays with the band. And I keep trying to get guys, come on, branch out a little, branch out. No, no, no. That's the way so-and-so did it. I'm not going to mess with that. Okay? And that's the wonderful tradition of alumni of being here. Same thing with the solos that I hear year in and year out. One guy or one gal decided on a solo, and that's it for the next 10 years. And I can't get them to break that habit. They won't do anything different because that's what they grew up with. It's comfort food, basically. It's mashed potatoes and gravy food. So that's the beauty of our tradition as we go. All right. You didn't think we'd go to mashed potatoes and gravy tonight, did you? All right. Okay, so our last number, too, is I'm trying to move quick because I'm anticipating 9 seniors talking, average 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes apiece. I'm trying to get you out of here in a timely manner. Again, another one of my favorite tunes, one of these guys' favorite tunes, The Boys Are Back in Town. One of the most requested ones from our girls' basketball team. The Boys Are Back in Town. Here we go. We'll be right back. Okay, so we gotta move. I need my piano players, all four of them, to move. We got some things that we need to do here. We got seniors that are gonna hurt. And suddenly, Blake, we're 45 minutes into this thing. I know I get the same reaction after we get done, thank goodness, that you say, we could listen to that all night. Well, that's nice. I've been at some concerts where they said, thank you for quitting, right? Thank goodness we haven't heard that a lot here in Colfax. So, we're going to get our seniors up on stage right now, okay, all nine of them, and we're going to, again, it's in my contract, and I have to say some nice things about the graduating seniors as they're going out. And it's a preemptive strike, basically, because I don't know what's coming. I don't know what's coming in their comments, so I've got to just kind of prepare myself. Here. The balloons are attached to the balloons are cards that I wrote to my seniors, and attached to that is candy that may or may not reflect my thoughts of their personality. I don't know. So it's always a mystery whether they look at that and not go, what does he mean by this? So, all right, here we go. Let's talk about the seniors. What a great group, honestly. And with all my alumni that have come through here, they have all. These guys started off with pups. Some of these guys, seventh grade. Why are you guys who started in seventh grade in here? Seniors. Good. And eighth graders. Okay. And then high school from there on. So some of these guys started. Some of these guys have been with me for 6 years, 5 years, 4 years. But have grown up with my alumni, those guys mentoring them. And now, all this year, these guys have done nothing but mentor everybody behind them. And they're going to be sorely missed. They are. I love their leadership this year. I love their sense of humor, apparently, as you can. Okay, their sense of humor. The seniors got to tell stories this morning to our group as they were bidding farewell. Their last morning of getting up at you know, the crack of dawn to be here. Before I get on to these guys, just a little bit further, I need the senior parents to please stand up. Everybody hold their applause. I guess I'm going to say, senior parents, please. Thank you guys, because these guys didn't always have driver's license, okay? Which means somebody had to get up early in the morning and drive these guys to jazz band and listen to them complain about their director all the way home at night and do all that type of stuff. I appreciate your investment in these young people. You've done a great job. And they're going to be great. Let's give our parents a big round of applause. Again, thank you. And to the community, thank you for raising such wonderful young people. Now, Carrie Larger, would you do me a favor? Would you stand up and unhook that microphone? So when I might play it later on, when you can come see, you're going to know exactly which one it is. Pass it along. Good. All the way down. Okay. I have a disclaimer. Whatever stories are told, please believe about 50% of them, because the others are embellished. These guys are like fishermen. No, they caught a great big fish. That's great about this. Okay. So whatever they have to say, just explain. All right, I'm going to turn it over to my seniors. Be kind.
As some of you know, one of Mr. Morgan's favorite nicknames to use is Slick. But for some odd, unknown reason, it's Jan and I, salt and pepper. Shirt with our faces on it. The original salt and pepper, if there happens to be another two. Overcome my shyness. There's not many people out in this world that genuinely care about others, but I can say that Mr. Morgan is one of the few people who are genuinely kind, caring, and thoughtful. So thank you for helping me. Get over my weaknesses and pushing me to be a better person. I'll always be thankful for the words of wisdom and the endless advice that you have to say to me, especially during the difficult times in life. So thank you for that. I'm so grateful and thankful that I had the opportunity to not only be in jazz band, but to be able to say that I was a part of Mr. Morgan's legacy and to be in his wonderful program that he's built. So thank you.
Turns out being 8:15. We got him a little something that keep the time.
So I didn't actually time it, so I don't know how long that is.
2 minutes.
Not me. I'd like to start off by saying that even though jazz band probably wasn't my greatest, most fun times in high school, it was definitely up there. You've been such a role model and such a help to all of us, I know, but especially me, like, saying, oh, how'd the game go, congrats on the game, congrats on all these different things that I didn't even know anyone really knew about until I woke up in the morning and came to your class. Another thank you, I guess, for calling Aiden and I twins every day. Yeah. I've also been really blessed to have AJ, my older brother, who's here, and me and Aiden were in jazz band all together last year, and AJ graduated, and now I was with my other two, Austin and Aiden. So we've had a lot of fun, I would say. It's been great. So thank you everyone for making the senior year fantastic, and thank you Mr. Morgan for all the hard work and effort you put into us.
Yes, we are playing today. And then this one, he has this like 3-string 0 rule, and you have to write out your music. And so this one, and we would always like start at the wrong spot. And so this one says, "Don't make me repeat myself."
Besides, one time I proved him wrong. our third song, Apollo is Real, we were playing it, and there was a high part where Riley was soloing, and he goes, "Are you playing that right?" I'm like, "Yeah." He goes, "Is that what the recording sounds like?" I'm like, "Yeah, you can check." Lo and behold, I was right, he was wrong. And that's the accomplishment of my life.
Last year we were playing a song and it had a well, it might be funny because it's us, but it's a picture of all of us after we played at Mount Hood this year. And so Mr. Morgan always says that, you know, the seniors, they'll just get replaced next year and they'll never even know that they're gone. But if you just want to put this up in a prominent display,
long talks, and he usually makes us late for class. Yeah, you guys can move in this person. Okay. But anyway, so before I joined jazz band, I was in seventh grade with you, and I did not know what a D-C was. Like, certain songs we like play third position, some songs we play second position, I had no idea what was going on. But, so I guess if it wasn't for Mr. Morgan, I wouldn't know what a key signature was today.
This is the comedy part of the show, ladies and gentlemen. Only Dean Ward could do this.
Okay, so he takes forever, so I have to devise a way to keep it. Okay, you gotta move it like out there. And you gotta like hold it. Is he still? Oh my god. I didn't talk more. Boy. Okay. Well, I was one of Coach Morgan's football teams. So that's fun. We've been really blessed to have such a good handwriting here.
I got it.
So he can like write all of his stuff, all of his speeches out on the internet, okay, with this website called Wix. I found this Wix. It's incredibly easy to make a website with Morgan. Embrace the bald spot. Yeah, it's a key to being a director. Those are all our rules. Did you know that? We have a lot of rules.
No, don't encourage it. Don't. It's like feeding the bear. It's more like this.
I can't read that. Okay, so his six rules are cookie dough, and I'll leave him to fill in the translations, but basically you want to blend all of the music together, otherwise you get a really bad taste of egg yolk. Lead sled dog. So all of the seniors, we kind of have a lot of responsibility being all these big dogs. So we have to keep the little ones in check, and so basically we have to tell them what to do, and they have to listen to us, no matter what. The big fish, he talks about this all the time as we come to the end of the school year. So I guess you know what that means. If you guys are moving out, another one's gonna take your place. Gene, I need you to step up, bro. I love you. Shoes in the dryer, it just basically means tap your foot. Does that thing work?
Yeah, it's working. You got 30 more seconds.
Okay, so that means we don't suck, and football is the answer to everything.
Through a little bit more. Stay there. Okay, stay there. Let's give these guys a big round of applause, man. Example tonight. You guys pick it up, make it go fast. Okay? My alumni out there, I don't really talk that long, do I?
Yes!
Right. I got a New Year's resolution. Talk half the length. How does that sound? Alright, so we've got one more tune for you tonight. We're going to finish off with a great trumpet beginning. One of my favorite bands. Anybody know who the band is? See, I taught them well. Little Kansas for your evening right here. As soon as we finish up playing tonight, these guys are going to go out there, take pictures, sign autographs, do all that kind of stuff. Again, I want to tell you, thank you so much for everything that you've done. Thank you, you guys out here, for these guys out here. And I mean that sincerely. What we do at Colfax, the product that we put out, is second to none, and we're proving that every place we go. Our kids from Colfax are well prepared. These guys are going to go out and just make a huge hit. I know it. I want to invite those guys to come back year after year after year. To the community, thank you so much for everything. Thanks for allowing me to come in and do what I do. So here it is. We'll carry on.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to meet you out in the foyer. Take your time. We've got no place to go. Thank you so much for being here. Have a great rest of the spring. Thank you. Good night.